Delicious foods.
Come here.
So we got members over there. We got some tax shit. They take cars. You got the tax shit. Come on, spend some of that money on some black owned business. Yeah. Make sure you network. If you got anything, going on. Whatever type of contract, you never know who you come in contact with. It may be the singer or the wedding. It may be somebody that you're with the pain. Something maybe in your past, and something happened in your past where you were little, something happened in your present. I'm going to start it off. And then I'm going to go around. I'm going to ask you for a crazy confession. Now, one thing I want you to understand, these crazy confessions, this is family. Whatever you say, we're not going to look at you any different. Maybe. Yeah, it just depends on what it is. So, let me give you my crazy confession, and then you know I'm gonna go around. I'm gonna get y'all in here because y'all going home and nobody gonna see y'all. We all know it's your family. So my crazy confession: when I was young, I used to love to smell the couch when people got up off, got off the couch or seat. Like when my aunties they would be over to the house, they'd be sitting on the couch with their. Sitting on the couch with that black dress on, And so what I would do is, I was a young boy, what I would do is, I would just act like I'm tying my shoe or something like that.
You
won't
act it out. No.
Auntie, let it stink. That's my crazy confession. So, I'm gonna come around. And I want you to tell us your crazy confession.
You got one lady?
Where you been?
How old is she?
How old are you?
You got glass eyes?
You been to New York.
You got a bus pass?
You been to the Pokemon?
Is that your mom?
Is that, you have kids?
Oh, that's your real hair?
Yeah.
Rocket ships filled with reasons to revel in your moon's beams. We bask in your daytime rays, and at night we find direction by following your glow. Even stars shadow over time, but stardust is nothing less than a magical sprinkle of purity and passion upon our hearts.
Is I can't stand stupid shit. Does anybody else have this disease in this motherfucker? It's called dumb stupid shit. I can't stand stupid shit. Stupid shit like. I hate to go to the grocery store and see a fat motherfucker in the grocery store ride around on one goddamn grocery store of brands. It pisses me the fuck off. It pisses me the fuck off, but it does. Them are for people with disabilities. You know, if your legs fucked up or something, you got a bad hip, you get on the grocery store huff around. Fat, that's not a disability. It's not. You're not supposed to be on that motherfucker. You won't ride around the grocery store on the grocery store, hover around, shopping and shit. You in the grocery store, you need to walk around that motherfucker five times before you pick up your first item. Yeah, and I seen the dumbest shit in the world the other day, y'all. I seen a lesbian couple. Stud. Pretty chick. Baby. Diapers, bottles. But it was the fucking Stud's baby. I said, who in the fuck Mammy Fresh? Who fucked you, Mammy? Who? Gary Gates, who got you pregnant? She's like, bruh, you know they all walk like that. Bruh, it was one of them nights. Bruh, you know they do head shit. Bruh. Fuck Mammy Fresh. I want to see your baby daddy, for real. For real. I do. It's fucked up. Y'all look stupid. I'm just trying to tell you. Look, it's some cool shit. I got a few lesbian friends. They all studs. But they fun in a motherfucker to go out and kick it with. It's like kicking it with your partners. Like, it's real fun with these motherfuckers and shit. You know what I'm saying? Fun as a motherfucker. Now, I got this one lesbian partner. She's a stud. This bitch is a little different, though. I call this bitch a super stud. The reason why I call this bitch a super stud is this bitch wore her dildo all the time. This bitch always walking around with her dildo on like she got a real dick and shit. Then I asked her about it. She's like, nigga, I'd rather be caught with than without. Hey, I just want to say thank y'all for allowing me to come up here tonight, man. I had a ball with y'all. This is a great crowd. I am comedian Chris Cognac. You can catch me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, comedian Chris Cognac. I do got DVDs for sale. If you like something you heard, I got some shit you ain't never heard on here. They $10 for y'all. They two for 20. Y'all should love it. Thank y'all.
Let's give it up for comedian Cognac. Yeah, I'm ready for Louisville. Listen, real quick, we're going to have we have what we call an interview. It's called 38 in part. 38
in part.
Not really. So what we do is we just ask you a couple questions. So how long have you been doing comedy?
On stage or being...
Just whatever. How long you been doing comedy?
Shit, I probably was born doing this shit, but I ain't know it. But actually doing comedy has probably been what? 3 years now? 3-4 years? 4 years? It'd be 4 years in August. Real talk. 4 years in August.
So you've been doing comedy for 4 years. Cool. So who are some of the comedians or artists that you, like your inspiration, whether they're local or national or international?
Man, I ain't gonna even lie. I'm gonna tell y'all some shit. When I was a little boy, I used to sneak in the basement and watch. Yep, I used to sneak and watch all the HBO and Showtime stuff. I'm talking about, I don't give a fuck who they was. Gallagher, motherfucking Bobcat Goldthwait, Eddie Murphy. I used to watch all these cats and never knew that this is what I would be doing later on in life. So all the great comedians influenced me, man.
All right, so once again, explain to the people, how can they get in touch with you? How can they follow you? And also your DVD or any other material that you have.
Get at me at Facebook at Chris Cognac or Comedian Cognac on Facebook. Instagram is Comedian Cognac 502. Twitter is Comedian Cognac. Just get at me, man. I'm here. I love y'all. You know what I'm saying? I had a ball coming up here. It's a great audience, man. I would love to come back if y'all would have me. How about that? Plus, I got DVDs for sale. They $10, but for y'all, matter of fact, they $2 for $15 right now. I'm good. You know how you go to the service and shit, and the shit started at $30. You can walk out of that motherfucker with a $5 toy. We don't.
I wanna run to the light. It's too dark in this part of night. I need somebody who can make it right. And it's on tonight. How about we go and save the night? I can see you want it so bright. How about we go?
Breath is like the missing puzzle piece to my existence. Resisting isn't an option, though. You rob me of every feeling that insists I run away you. Silence the voices that suggest anything remotely rational. I lose all rationale when I'm with you. Your eyes can see behind the lies I tell. But to think that I want to slow down when the only thing I want to stop is time. So I can get lost in your touch just the way I lose myself in my thoughts of you. And my biggest fear is that you would speak life into my fantasies, breathe breath into my daydreams, and surrender yourself into my essence, essentially. I'm afraid that you would take me as your own. And I really want to be yours, I want to be yours more than I want son of my melanin. I want to be yours more than I want Obama as president. I want to be yours like I blood pressure need medicine. I just want to be yours. I hope it's everything.
When you get mad at him and you be like, man, this nigga didn't call me, he didn't text me, it's 409, he know he's supposed to text me back at 407. Don't play with me.
What?
It's the dopamine. Y'all know when y'all be like, love make you do crazy things. I mean, crack make you do crazy things too. So when dopamine is being released, your ass is addicted. You gotta keep going back to it. Anybody else got kids?
Yeah.
Look, you got kids.
No.
Tell me your kids, shit. If y'all can't tell, I'm a brand new mother. I've been a mother for the last 7 years. The shit is still new to me.
Say it.
Shit, I learn something new every day. I got a little boy, he's 7 years old. And he nasty as shit.
Wait a minute.
You gotta teach your sons. I believe all boys is just nasty off bat.
No.
Okay.
No.
So if you know you gotta teach your sons. Like, I mean, my son, he be in playing target practice with the toilet bowl. I go in there, it's urine and shit. All around the toilet, you gotta put your Clorox on hand. Clorox, Lysol, disinfectant wipes on hand. Shit.
So I said, fuck this. I ain't playing no police. I ain't gonna get his ass whooped. I am type bitch. I whoop a nigga too, though. You know what I mean? But I ain't gonna do it. I sat there and I looked at him. He all propped up, feet all on the table. I looked at him again. Fuck this shit. I'm ready to do this shit. I ain't a motherfucking book. He looked at me, y'all. I thought this was it. It's over. He said, did you just see the damn book? Yeah, baby, I just ate the book. Well, we made for each other. I ain't really sure.
Niggas always wanna play with me. Don't play, tell them don't play. Yeah. And hey. Yeah. This shit can happen any given day. Shit. That's why I gotta keep my don't play, listen. Don't play with this profit. You'll probably be hard pressed to find a way to make my crown tarnish.
I told you before that I see deeper than fourth degree burns. Born with a third eye and a soul that yearns in the truth and all its purpose. I hold the surface of trust, loyalty, and love. Don't let the plethora of my intelligence allow you to think my common sense doesn't reign above. Your pretentious foolishness, your fault for mistaking the paucity of my flesh as a weakness. Well, in other words, don't let my hype fool you and fall asleep on my royalty due. Cause the fire I spit from my tongue like a rapid fire HK with a banana clip would knock your self-security 8 feet deep under my feet like the rest of the weak ones. Red rum in my veins is the attempt at these lame games give me a migraine. Cause now I have to lay you on your back and burn this lyrical fire through your soul. Cause your eyes have deceived you. You let the cute dimples on my face and the way them jeans fit my waist mislead you. I'm a rare breed dude and your jean pool is see-through.
From the 30 to block, you see you get it for hop, you get a hold of some money, I be that right there. If you ain't trying to get it, my name, bite down, bite down, bite down, bite down, hey, if you ain't trying to get it, my nigga, if you ain't trying to get it, hey, work to your bone, turn school to your brain pop. Puss up from the 30 to block, you see you get it for hop, you get a hold of some money, I be like right now. If you ain't trying to get it, my nigga, bite down, bite down, bite down.
Spending more time on faith and meditation, on family and relation, on diet and exercise, and not all of us and not all together, but each of us addressing that piece of us, putting together the puzzle of this existence. This life we can't remember but keep dreaming about over and over.
Why, the who, and how I have been able to recreate my creativity. Her every move gives play to new inspiration, enhancing my relaxation and fueling my dedications when tight with my brand of vernacular, speaking to you and how her light speaks to and through me. She makes me better, and often I make her wetter than oceans could ever do, and she gets me to get deep in her nestles. I find the greatest and most comforting of all things. Her heartbeat is more rhythmic than the guitar strings, but I...
Cognac still selling some DVDs if you want to buy one, buy two, buy three. All right. Thank you for coming to the Greenhouse. God bless.
Yeah.